Hi, this presentation will serve an introduction to a series that covers all aspects of acute ischemic stroke and its management. I am Li Qing, and here with me is Dr. Sunny. These are the topics that we are covering today. Definition of stroke in Singapore, types of stroke, common and uncommon stroke symptoms. How do we define stroke? As we know that stroke occurs due to disruption of blood supply to the brain. In 1970, the World Health Organization defined stroke as rapidly developing clinical sign of focal or global disturbance of cerebral function lasting more than 24 hours or leading to death, with no apparent cause rather than that of vascular origin. However, with advances in neuroimaging and a better understanding of pathophysiology, this definition has become obsolete. Operationally, stroke is now best defined as a sudden onset of neurological deficit, resulting from spontaneous hemorrhage or infarction of the central nervous system, with objective evidence of infarction or hemorrhage, irrespective of duration of clinical symptom. Stroke is the second most common cause of death worldwide, after ischemic heart disease. As per statistic in 2009, one stroke was known to occur every 2 seconds. In Singapore, stroke is the number one cause of adult disability and the fourth leading cause of death. Almost 10% of stroke patients admitted to hospital do not survive. In 2014, the National Registry of Disease Office reported nearly 7,000 cases of stroke. With increasing aging population, these figures are expected to rise. The median age for first ever stroke admitted to hospitals was 66 years, and among adults, stroke is more common in males. Most of the strokes in Singapore are ischemic type, which account for almost 85% of all stroke cases.
Ischemic stroke is defined as clinical symptoms of stroke that persist for more than 24 hours, plus an objective evidence of infarction on either imaging or on pathology. Conversely, focal arterial ischemia with transient symptoms lasting less than 24 hours and without any evidence of infarction by pathology or brain imaging should be considered a transient ischemic attack or a TIA. As you will have noted, the definition of ischemic stroke is now tissue-based. It does not include global ischemia that may occur after hypoxic ischemic injuries, for example, in cardiogenic shock or acute cardiac syndromes. Though this definition increases the diagnostic accuracy, there are 2 points that must be emphasized. 1. Diagnosis of acute ischemic stroke does not require persistence of clinical symptoms for equal to or more than 24 hours. 2. Not all ischemic strokes are evident on brain imaging. In fact, up to 7% of acute ischemic strokes may not have any imaging evidence of infarction even on MRI. Ischemic strokes account for 85% of strokes. The other strokes include the bleeding type of strokes, which includes intracerebral hemorrhage, in which bleeding occurs into the brain parenchyma or the ventricles, or subarachnoid hemorrhage, in which bleeding occurs into the subarachnoid space. In both these cases, trauma must be excluded as a cause of bleeding. A less common type of stroke is cerebral venous thrombosis, which occurs due to thrombosis in either the cerebral veins or the dural venous sinuses. Symptoms of stroke are determined by the area of brain involved. Focal symptoms tend to predominate over the non-focal symptoms. The commonest symptoms of stroke include focal weakness, focal loss of sensation, and speech problems, which include aphasia or dysarthria. Amongst the non-focal symptoms, headache is the commonest. Notably, patients with isolated numbness or visual symptoms are less likely to seek medical attention. FAST is an acronym that helps improve the detection and enhances responsiveness to patients with stroke. It has been widely used for public education purposes. You will note that it includes all the common focal stroke symptoms. F stands for facial droop, A for arm weakness, S for speech problems, while T emphasizes time to seek and attain medical attention.
Symptoms of stroke may also depend on the type of stroke. Headache and seizure are more common in hemorrhagic stroke, while sensory symptoms and speech abnormality are seen more commonly in patients with ischemic stroke.
Approximately 14% of ischemic stroke patients do not have any of the FAST symptoms at presentation. These patients may present with difficulty in balance or walking, visual symptoms like diplopia or visual field defects, dizziness or vertigo, and other non-specific symptoms. Addition of a history of gait imbalance, leg weakness, or visual symptoms to the usual FAST symptoms improves the detection of stroke. Atypical symptoms of stroke may include non-specific complaints like fatigue and tiredness. These symptoms are more common in females. They may be seen in approximately 70% of women and 60% of men presenting with acute stroke symptoms. Though common stroke symptoms help in the diagnosis of stroke, stroke may be missed or may even be misdiagnosed if we rely solely on the presenting symptoms. This occurs more commonly in patients with posterior circulation strokes, where symptoms like nausea and dizziness may be attributed to peripheral vestibular disorders. Thus, a detailed examination as well as brain imaging are crucial to identify stroke in patients where either the history cannot be confirmed, for example, in patients who are aphasic or in patients with dementia, or symptoms are non-specific, or in patients where symptoms are suggestive but not confirmatory for a focal ischemic neurological event.
Stroke is a medical emergency, in particular for patients with ischemic stroke. Time is brain. With each minute of delay in diagnosis, brain damages accumulate. Timely recognition of stroke is crucial for initiation of measures that limit permanent brain damage. We hope that by now you are familiar with stroke as well as the symptom of stroke.